Wow.
So when I'm setting up for a shoot, which I equate to your race, I get nervous and I can't find things that I want and I get worked up. And do you have the same issue on race day?
Well, if I was having to do it all by myself, I might, but I don't. I'm pretty lucky because in our partnership, like I said, David likes to, he's the one that likes to work on the car and make it go fast. We've got five other guys that help us. So my main thing I have to do is drive the car, and then I also pack the parachutes, help with fuel and a few other things, unless we really get into a thrash. But basically, I don't get too nervous until it's time to get in the car, and then once I get in the car, I just kind of have to take a step back, calm down, and just relax for a minute or two, you know.
Do you ever like get in the zone or tunnel vision, or you still notice what's going on all around?
Well, I see what's going on close to me. It's not like I know what's going on at the other end of the track or anything, of course, but yeah, I see what's going on close to me. And a lot of times the other guys will come over, the other drivers, and we remind each other, give each other good luck, remind each other to be safe, and those kinds of things. And so yeah, I'm not total tunnel vision, no.
Is there anything someone suggested to me, like if I had the drone in the air, when you guys saw it might distract you? Would that distract you if you saw just something sitting in the air out in front of you when you're getting ready to, when you're staging?
Well, if it was sitting in the air by the Christmas tree or something, 15 feet off the ground, it might, yeah. Most of the time, I've raced a lot of tracks where guys use drones to film here in the last few years. And they've never bothered me yet, anyway. People were running them, I think, had them in such a place that it wasn't a factor. But unless it was right in front of me, then yeah, it could be distracting. But if it's not, no, it wouldn't bother me.
What influenced you to get started in this sport?
Well, it would have to be my dad. I can't remember exactly how old I was the first time I was at a drag strip, but I was probably 7 or 8. And my dad was a racer. He was partners with Jerry Moody, Keenan's dad. Those guys raced together for just about 40 years, I think, before they...
40?
40, yeah, 4-0. Before they
didn't
totally
they have a shop
quits.
Out here not far from where we're at now here in Liberty?
Well, Jerry owned an auto parts store and machine shop, yeah.
Carney? It was in Carney, wasn't it?
It was in Excelsior Springs.
Oh, yeah,
also had one in Northtown. I actually worked for him after I got out of high school in the early 70s, mid 70s. Almost 5 years I worked there, and down in the North Kansas City store.
Sure you leave when I come over here.
You want me to act like I'm doing something? That's the whole reason I did, Chris.
We'll mic you up here in a minute.
At least it's not witch fun.
Well, you know what? You don't have enough.
That's what I was thinking. Like one thread.
We don't have enough. I thought there was a lot more sticking out of there.
Yeah, talk to them.
So I ordered 5 deals from T&D.
You'll get your turn.
You know what's the stupid part? I was looking at those type of nuts online. Master car.
On what?
I'm glad you're here, man.
Master car. Industrial supplier. And they were like $3.
You up at 7 and I won't be late. Yeah.
Fuel flowing
through
the
idle. Okay. Well, I always feel and make sure they've got some kind of temperature in them. But.
Yeah, I guess I put the O-rings in. I just took it apart and looped it up.
This
yeah.
Here?
Mm-hmm. 9 times out of 10 is going to be that.
I had adjusted it. Yeah, I know. I didn't take it off or adjust it.
Does it only do it when it's running? Does it seem free when it's running? It's just not shutting
it
off?
It is now.
I know, but when it's running, it's still free. It's not in a bind. It's just not shutting the fuel off.
Yeah.
Okay.
I guess we'll wheel it in and take it apart again.
That was on here. We had the shifter sit at 6,000, so it hit second gear just as soon as I left the starting line.
Well, that's what I told you.
That's what exactly what it sounded like.
It looked like it went right into high gear. Because I knew you didn't leave with it because you had your training.
But that would make sense.
There you go. That with a couple of cylinders out of whack.
You may be in business.
Yeah.
Are you giving the battery? Does that sound kind of weird?
That sounded a little high.
It did.
Let's hang on a second. Well,
hi, what you're saying had a timing line.
What you hear? The charger's under the workbench. Just push this thing back up and get on the charger. Turn the wheel to your left if you want
to. Whoa, right there. It's
in park.
That's pretty cool. Yeah, that's my shot. Yeah. It looked like you were exactly what I thought they did. On the line.
Hold on.
I know. The fingers were under there. The pinpoint.
They're going to call us up in 10 minutes.
Around in your head. Did you know his dad used to drive race cars for my dad? Okay.
Didn't I tell you they worked together and they were partners?
Yeah, I knew your dad.
You weren't listening, were you? You're too worried about being a movie.
Wait till I tell you who I remember.
Oh, man.
Do you believe the royal family?
So it's got to be about Diamond Dunn, doesn't it? See, I'm trying to tell a little story.
You didn't get your name.
It's a funny story.
Here. I'll bring you here.
It's a funny story.
There's your royalties, Don.
I need some.
There's your royalties.
I need some. This for you.
We got a little bit of a little hair. We got Nancy.
Yeah.
We got.
Okay. I'm Gerald Kramer, owner of this place. Welcome everybody back. It's been a fantastic event every year. Little change up this year. We allow the night for 23rd. We got two open here. Glad to have Baz and Nancy. Very. The sad news that I got from this guy is he's leaving our country next year and won't be back. He's been here night of fire for a long time. And boy, we'll miss you, Baz.
Thank you.
Thank you. Appreciate that.
You guys mind if I fit in right here?
Bob Bench, you guys have all been working with him all day. He's the one that's going to get you to the lanes. Dan Driscoll is also here, but he's got some hard issues that I don't want him stressed out, so he'll probably spend more time in the tower. Most of it's going to be on him. He asked you to move to the lanes. Please cooperate with him. Anything you have to say about
No, I pretty much talk to most of the drivers. The only thing that we do, neck alternate lanes, and tonight, even though it's a lighter night because it's just a test to do,
it's when we fire.
The second one, but if, you know, we don't have sportsman racers to contend with, but when we come around, we want to run pairs only unless there's a reason that somebody needs a single, like they have a car or something like that. So if you come up and all of a sudden I've got six or eight cars on the right lane, we're going to put you in the lane because we're going to run pairs. And then tomorrow, you have to switch lanes anyway. So that's about the only thing for tonight. Just, you know, if we're down to singles, somebody's going to tell you to move.
That's tonight. We will offer at 6 o'clock, which is about an hour away from here. Anybody that wants a test yet does not have to qualify. It's don't count for nothing other than if you want the run, half run, whatever you want, be in the lanes, and we're going to use lanes 1 and 2, which are the furthest lanes, long fence there. So that's two lanes we use them throughout the weekend. And so 6 o'clock, we'll be calling it over the PA, bringing the cars to the lanes. We're going to be running testing tunes out of the other lanes, all of our sportsman cars. 8 o'clock, we're close to it, not before, maybe a little later. You know, I'd rather be later, no big deal. We've got, if you haven't been here before, I think we got as good a lighting as you'll find on any track anywhere. I don't think there's many tracks that could be better than what we've got the lighting. So we got good night time running, tough conditions. That'll be at 8 o'clock. That's our first qualifier. The other qualifier is tomorrow at 3. I want to introduce Fire Chief Rick. Where are you at? He's the guy that's going to be in charge at the far end. And anybody that's been here knows he does his duties well. The fire department will be here in force later tonight and for tomorrow. They can respond to anything. And we had one on the 4th of July, and they did amazing work. When you go past him, he's going to be following you around the corner there.
I need some gas money.
Oh, well, I just ran out of bread, and that's the only thing I dread. I don't got any money, cause I spent it on my honey, so I'm going home to bed. I need some gas money. I need some gas money. Well, if you really want to go, you better come up with some dough. I need some gas.
That was, but you gotta go back now all the way around, right? Yeah. Now we're down.
Gotta watch it open and close.
Now, when you get a little bit better at it, you can focus on about three of them at the same time. That way, you don't have to do as much.
Okay. So there you'd be.
You see, that's how you're a virgin on them. Let's just do it like this.
Hey, do we have our weather thing out too?
Yeah, we will. We need that. All right.
Well, we'll talk about that after the fire.
Yeah.
I don't think we brought it.
We never take it out.
Yeah, it's. Yeah, I'll look for it.
I can't find it.
It's not a big deal this go around.
It's heavy when it's.
Ready?
I said that, it feels crispy.
Sounds good.
Sounds good, yeah.
I mean, especially for what air is there.
Oh, yeah, Matt, speaking of air, let's get our weather station out and see where we're at. What pill do we have in it? Let's check to see what that is. It should be either 25 or 35.
I think it's a 30 or pull your fuel shut up, Donnie. All right, go ahead, pull it.
It's pulled.
Is that off or on?
It's off.
Okay, turn it on. Yeah, it's working now.
It wasn't before.
It was off.
Well, it didn't when we started it up the other last night. I couldn't push it on to open it, but I could pull the lever out. But when we went to kill it, it did just what it did then. It
just didn't do nothing.
Well, it was leaning it, but it wasn't totally killing
it. It wasn't leaning it out enough.
Yeah, I mean, the RPMs were coming up, but it was right. Like it's going halfway or something.
Right. Okay. That number 7 nozzle didn't feel cold at all, to me, is what I was trying to tell you.
Oh, it's got a real small nozzle. Shouldn't have any fuel flowing to it tonight.
Okay. Well, I was feeling make sure they've got some kind of texture in them.
I just took it apart and looped it up.
This
year? I didn't
take it off and adjust it. Did it only do it when it's running? Does it seem free when it's running? It's just not shutting it off?
It is now.
I know, but when it's running, it's still free. It's not in a bind. It's just not shutting the fuel off. Okay. Did you have it apart?
Yeah, I looped it up. I'll put some more rings in it this time.
Check that brake trigger and make sure it's okay. As tight as what you want it. You want Nitro Madness
doing it. We got mud drags in the morning, and then we're going to come back over here. It's a Lamoni
Iowa. We don't want to do that.
Because then
we'll have to eat. We might.
Cool.
If we do it
first,
that's right. That's a good movie, isn't it? Shake and bake.
Stuff all day.
What do you call it when you go around
well,
a car really quick?
What happens tonight is we run our qualifying session on the first one.
Woo! Yeah, baby!
Eddie,
Yeah, he said nobody got it.
Well, he almost called the cops on me. That was stopping me pretty good.
Right? Go check that other car out. Okay, he's pretty fascinated.
Go check that car out. Have fun.
All right.
Starving.
Yeah, I haven't eaten nothing either.
I thought there was going to be barbecue, somebody told me.
Team
right.
We're yeah, you know. We're blaming it on him. He's way up there.
I don't even know if that barbecue could hold a hot dog. It'd probably fall over.
We'll eat when we're done.
Eat something. When will we be done?
After we make this run.
That's it? This is it?
Tonight. Go back to the pit. do what we need to do.
How was your other run?
A little bit loose towards the finish line. It was spinning the tires some. That wasn't terrible.
Get a little close with my partner there, buddy. What's going on?
I didn't hear you. What'd you say?
You're getting a little close with my partner. I'm a little worried.
Oh.
She's a sweetie, isn't she? All right, buddy, good luck. We'll see you over there.
Yeah, I got that spot. Yeah.